There's another issue caused as the FM professional tries to manage, direct, and control the FM vendor. And this is a problem that is at the core of the supply chain services. We would think that the owners who are managing, directing, and controlling the vendors is the root of the problem. But it's actually not. If someone has enough information and enough experience, they have seen this happen. If the FM professional is an information worker, if they truly can identify and utilize expertise, it actually requires the FM associate or expert vendor to be able to identify and utilize expertise in their own organization. I have seen this many times. This is what happens. Let's say this is an organization. They have five people. Of the five people, this is the owner of the organization. This is the owner's son. This is the person who has been in the organization for the longest possible period of time. They are known as the very experienced party in the organization. This individual here, number four, is always available. Why? No one knows, but they're always available. And this person in the organization just happens to be the youngest and the newest hire. This person hasn't even been in the organization for a year. But everyone knows, since that person entered the organization, that that person is the expert. If you have a problem, this person can solve it. Whether it's supply chain problems, whether it's a humanistic relationship problem, or whether it's simply a logic problem, this newcomer in the organization can solve the problem, explain it to everyone, and get rid of the problem. So, let's review this. This is a small organization. This is the owner of the organization. This is the owner's son. This is the most experienced person in the organization. They have been in the organization the longest and knows the whole corporate history. This person is always available, and this is the newcomer in the organization, but they're the expert. Now, this organization hears that an FM professional wants to identify and utilize expertise of expert vendors. And they want to change the paradigm. Instead of managing, directing, controlling, they want the expert to be accountable. They want the expert to see into the future. They want the expert to increase the value of the services and of the facility, but decrease cost. The word gets out to this organization. Now we have a problem. And the problem is, the owner hears of the requirement to have expertise. And the owner is trying to decide who he should send. Should it be his son? Should it be the person who has the most experience in the company? Should it be the person who's always available? Or should it be the youngest person in the organization who has shown their expertise in a very short period of time? This is the problem that this organization has. The boss has to make a decision, because if the boss didn't make a decision and knew that they were supposed to send this person to the FM professional and his organization, they have to have an explanation to his son, to the person who has the most experience and the person who's available, who always goes when they're available. Wow. This is the dilemma that every vendor organization is in. Many times, the owner doesn't even know of the expert. Many times, if some project seems to be very important, the owner only trusts his family. And if he doesn't send the most experienced person, he then has to have a very good explanation of why that person isn't good enough. This is the problem that we face in the supply chain. We'll be discussing this in the presentation on the FM professional of the future and how technology has to be utilized to save the FM profession by increasing professionalism, increasing responsibilities, increasing value, and decreasing costs. There is no magic about this. Come and see me at IFMA Worldwide, and we'll have a wonderful hour where you can sit and hear the answer that will be as simple as what I've explained to you now. Look forward to seeing you.